Thank you. Storm Center for the Performing Arts. Please take a moment to locate your nearest emergency exit. And out of respect for the artists on stage, as well as the other audience members, we ask that you turn off your cell phones now and refrain from texting during the show. As mandated by federal copyright law, any form of unauthorized recording or photography is strictly prohibited. There will be no intermission. Thank you, and enjoy the performance.
Thank you. Well, good evening, and thank you so much for joining us tonight. As most of you probably know, this outstanding group in front of you was selected to perform at this year's VMEA, the Virginia Music Educators National Association convention here in Virginia, which takes place in Richmond on Thursday and Friday. So the concert we're doing tonight is the same show that we're going to be playing at that convention on Friday afternoon at 4 o'clock. Often at these things, we always want to feature various soloists, so we're going to have a couple of soloists tonight, and the first one is about to happen. One of the great things about teaching here at JMU is all the wonderful colleagues in the faculty that I get to work with every day. And so tonight we're going to feature our clarinet professor, Dr. Sharunas Yannikauskas, so let's welcome him to the stage.
Thank you.
things that take place at conference performances, the idea of playing new music or music that people might not know that well, because it's the whole idea of the conference is to become exposed to things and learn about different things. But I also think it's important to play at least one piece that everybody just knows, loves, and adores, and that is the next piece. It's one of the great pieces in the wind band repertoire. It's by Percy Granger, who was very friendly to the wind band. This is his children's march. Percy Granger. Sorry, going to say somebody else there for a second. Percy Granger wrote this in like around 1919, and during that time, he was serving in a U.S. Military band during World War I. And so a lot of the pieces that he wrote were actually during that time period while he was in one of the military bands. One of the things that's very unique to this piece in 1919 is that it features the piano. Of course, Granger was a pianist, a concert pianist himself. But it was very unusual, first of all, to have original works that early in the wind band history, but also to have a wind band piece that has a featured piano throughout the whole piece. And there's another interesting twist in this, that there is some singing. So lots of interesting things for 1919 in the wind band world.
Thank you.
just a quick word about this next piece, because this is probably a piece that most people don't know yet. Chou Tian is a Chinese composer who came to the United States in his late teens, I believe, and he's now on the faculty, composition faculty at Michigan State. And he's fairly new to writing for the wind band world. This is the first piece I've done of his, but he's an exciting new voice, I look forward to all the new pieces he's going to write in the future. This is his Petals of Fire.
Thank you.
Well, it's time for our second soloist of the evening, and this is a bit unusual because usually when we go to VMEA and other places like that, we're always featuring our faculty, which is obviously great, but this time we're also featuring one of our students. Andrew, who you're about to meet, just finished his undergraduate degree in music education this last May, and he's now starting his master's in performance here. But over the summer, he won what's called the Falcone Prize, which, if you know the euphonium world, that is as good as it gets in the United States. You can't achieve any higher award than winning this contest. So it was a no-brainer that we need to show Andrew off a little bit. So he's going to come out here and play for you a wonderful piece by Peter Graham called Brillante.
Thank you.
And now for the grand finale. We are so excited to have Omar Thomas with us tonight. Omar is an alum of JMU, and he has gone out and done just amazing things in the jazz world, and more recently in the wind band world. He is like the hottest thing out there, winning all kinds of awards. And I won't say too much about this piece because he's going to come up and say a little bit about it. But please welcome to the stage Omar Thomas.
Dukes. Man, what a pleasure and honor it is to be asked to come back and to give back to this institution that has done so much for me in my life, and to be in front of this incredible ensemble that I've had the pleasure of playing in several decades ago. So this piece that you're about to hear, evil laugh, I started off wanting to write something funk-based for wind ensemble. I'm gonna get rid of this. There we go. This feels a lot better. It's kind of been my pedagogical mission, both as a professor and as a composer, to introduce our students to music that probably doesn't exist in certain spaces, and to make that space. And so I'm a firm believer that even though there are different accents, and different dialects, and different culturally rooted slangs, that ultimately we're all speaking the same language. And it's very important that in the year of our Lord 2022 and beyond, that we are creating spaces for our students to learn about one another through our different musical languages. So I set out to create a piece rooted in funk for an ensemble that doesn't traditionally get to do that. And when I was searching for models of how that was done, I happened upon blaxploitation soundtracks, right? And we're talking about Shaft, we're talking about Dolomite, we're talking about Foxy Brown. It just so happens that the composers of those scores are some of the biggest names in Black American music of the 20th century. Earth, Wind, and Fire, Marvin Gaye, Isaac Hayes, Curtis Mayfield, and so on and so forth. And so when I was listening to these soundtracks doing my research, I realized that this world was so much bigger than funk. There was jazz, there was the blues, there was early hip hop, there was R&B, and there was also film noir. So I decided to kind of expand the scope of what I had set out to do and to create a soundtrack for a non-existent blaxploitation film. So that's what you're about to hear. This is the Lowdown Brown Get Down. You'll hear a number of nods to, of course, the Godfather of Soul, James Brown. And you will follow our character through a day in the life of a lot of misdeeds and misfortunes that will end in a car chase. So this is the Lowdown Brown Get Down. Again, it's such an honor to be here and to be able to share this music with you. So thank you all so much.